For the past 7 years, I have been playing around with cool ideas, trying to make electronics simpler and robots smaller. But so far, everything I've made was just prototyping. And moving forward, I don't want my projects to end with just YouTube videos. The only way to reach their true potential is by treating them as products. So the first step to make this possible is to launch a robotics startup, and we're calling it microbots.io. Thanks for the confetti, Luke. With the help of my cousin Luke, I've been trying to figure out how to make smaller robots, super cool displays, and other maker-friendly electronics. Most of the cool stuff is still on the way, but hopefully it's all coming this new year. So, to kick things off, I would like to start by re-engineering some of my previous Flexar kits, and also explain my new vision. It all has to do with this guy. This controller was perfect for helping others get started with controlling PCB actuators. It lets you adjust the driving waveform by just turning a screwdriver. But the problem is that most of its components are very expensive, which brings the selling price way up. It's also very thick when you consider that the whole point of PCB actuators is to have something flat. After considering many iterations, the best way forward was just to create the smallest H-bridge module, which I decided to call drive cell. It's just 1 by 0.8 centimeters, and on this tiny board it has the same H-bridge driver, the coupling capacitors, and an LED. So it's very simple, but this thing alone is dumb. So what I did is took the smart elements of the other driver and put it into an Arduino library. This way people can just program it by using examples and customize anything. So you can drive a motor forward, reverse, slowly drive PWM, go to higher frequencies, and also make buzzing sounds. All this means that I have a super lightweight new solution for all these other actuators. But is it actually needed? The cool thing about PCB actuators is that they are made from a circuit. So why the heck do I have to connect it to another board to control the coil? We could have everything built in. To truly understand the answer of this question, we have to separate the actuators into two groups. One where the magnet is being actuated, and the other where the coil is being actuated. For the scenario where we have the coil fixed, it makes perfect sense to have a built-in driver. And that's what I did here. We have the same exact circuit on a 4-layer board. This was tested for days to make sure that the heat generated by the coil doesn't affect the circuit with time. The copper underneath the coil also doesn't affect the magnetic performance. Fun fact, it's only affected when the magnets are moving really fast, aka PCB motors. The only thing that was magnetic is the 22 microfarad capacitor, but going for a smaller package minimized the effect. We are calling this one a coil cell because the goal is to have multiple coils rather than just one. Each cell has 4 pads that can be soldered with neighbor cells, sharing the power or control signals. This would at least reduce 2 of the 4 wires. And for those who hate soldering, it also comes in a 5-cell package that has VCC and ground shared inside the PCB. Now these pads are not perfectly aligned at the center, which is kind of bugging me, but the concept here is that it will align to a smarter controller, which we'll talk about in another video. But for now, the main applications for the coil cell include jumping magnets, vibrating lightweight objects, and linearly sliding magnets. We are also using the same coil cell to experiment with other applications like magnetic dice, flip dots, and adding more coils. But anyways, for now, let's talk about this other group. Usually these are connected onto lightweight surfaces and have to be soldered to wire. So this is why it makes sense to have a drive cell. But the question is, how can I make them better for people to use? For the sticker actuators, it's easier to answer because there are so many applications for it. We just decided to remove the holes, make the area smaller, make it PCB solderable, and give it an awesome new name, coil pad. The thin flat flap is a different story because for the last couple of months I have been kind of struggling to understand why it needs to exist. It was designed to survive millions of flaps, but its force is very weak. This is not a huge problem for fast flapping applications. In fact, I'm basing my upcoming floating display on the same tech, but for slower movements the force drops. So to improve it, I had to think about the application. First, I wanted to test what's called gecko tape, which was shown in Vertasium's video last year. Putting some on the flap could perhaps act as a robotic finger. After the parcel arrived, I quickly realized that no carpooling was going to happen with this one. It was a different Gecko adhesive brand, which is typically used for reusable sticky paper. So the actuator didn't work even close to what I had in mind. The real thing cost $1,000 per sheet. So unfortunately, this idea was no longer feasible. The other application was inspired by mechanical mirrors to create a pixel that can go bright and dark, depending on the angle. I simplified this further by replacing the tape with a thin aluminium stiffener. This is just 0.3 mm thick, so it wasn't that heavy for the coil to push it up. The laser cutting made it look way more professional than my hand cut version. And the cool thing is that Pisbuey doesn't charge extra for this one additional stiffener.
It's also reflecting light very well.
I 3D printed this mount that could hold a 3x3 matrix. The contrast between bright and dark pixels started to show a little bit better here, especially when you light it up from the top. It's kind of like a huge DLP.
What's worrying me is the power, because it is very hungry. 9 of these are consuming 5 watts.
The problem here is that the flaps are non-latching, so it always needs power to maintain its state. Similar displays are also non-latching, but some kind of mechanism would be required to add 100 of these pixels. So for now, I decided to focus on making the little one better and prettier. I started by testing reflective stickers. From the 4 I tested, the best looking one was the blue and pink reflector. Its color change based on the angle you look at it from. To improve this further, I made the reflector squared, which filled the area more. I also added 2 other rows and a drive cell to each flap to create a 7-segment display. Kind of have to tilt it a certain way to bring out the effect, but that looks pretty cool. Now this is just a fancy art project, but all the 3D printed files are available for anyone to try it out. It is an expensive project and it has a lot of wares, but like I said, with this we're still experimenting with adding more and making things simpler. Also, who knows, maybe someday we'll be turning it into a dress. Now we do have one more thing we'd like to show about this flap. The new aluminium stiffener also allows you to directly connect other lightweight materials to it, including paper butterfly wings. This is probably the most popular application for this actuator. After searching for some inspiration, I used Altium to design a flexible PCB and fold it into a butterfly. I think this really shows the capabilities of the software, because it's not just about engineering good circuits, but also making it look nice. So if you'd like to try Altium Matrix 5, click the link in my description. I think flexible PCBs were made to be turned into pretty yellow butterflies. Their dielectric is a transparent yellow color, which brings out an interesting effect. Something like this can never fly because it's just too weak. We're still trying to figure out if, for example, people would be interested in decorating their home with something like this. If you are, please put your email address here. But we are planning on making this even cooler and show it in a future separate video, because this first prototype still needs some improvements. But it's definitely another cool application for this type of actuator. If you like what I'm doing, please check out microboss.io, and huge thank you to all my Patreons for their incredible support.